I got an autograph from Chris Barry, you know, from Red Dwarf, the classic English comedy.
Oh, man.
I got an autograph from him just by sending him a note saying, can I have one?
I would have said this guy could have played Rimmer, but he's way too good looking, actually. He's way too handsome. That's the thing, though. Another thing about Harry Von Gorkum I found out was apparently, you know, in the mid-90s when they tried to, like, reboot Doctor Who before it was, they successfully rebooted it in the mid-2000s.
Oh, he could be Doctor Who.
Well, he was apparently hired to play the Doctor in the mid-90s in the Paul McGann movie, when Paul McGann ended up playing the part.
You know what? That's the first time I saw Doctor Who was that movie.
Yeah, and weirdly enough, freaking had Eric Roberts in it, who went on to, you know, he ended up being a, you know, a villain in The Dark Knight. So there you go, everything's good. But apparently the producers just weren't they weren't happy with Harry, so they sacked him and they got in Paul McGann to play the part. But the thing is, I looked at him and I was kind of like, yeah, he's too good looking to play Doctor Who, like, because I know people have a thing for David Tennant and even Matt Smith. Weirdly enough, I think Matt Smith's quite a bit weird looking.
Yeah, but Matt Smith's like one of those who, he's interesting looking. You know what I mean? I don't mean that as a diss. I mean, like, he's unique, which is attractive in a way.
Yeah. And I kind of get David Tennant's like, oh, he's a good looking guy, but he's not like astoundingly looking good, you know, good looking guy. This guy is like, oh yeah, he's hot. Like, if he was the Doctor, I'd be like, he's too dashing. he's too like chiseled and handsome.
What's his face? The Scottish fella.
Chris Eccleston.
No.
Oh, Peter Capaldi.
Anyway. Peter Capaldi. He's handsome. He's a daddy. He's a zaddy.
Yeah. But yeah, I think everyone else, you know, you're thinking back to classic, like, oh yeah, like, because he would have been taken over from Sylvester McCoy. And like, Sylvester McCoy had a cool outfit, but he wasn't like a good looking guy. But yeah. So like, I can understand. It's like, yeah, I don't know. It would have, you know, it's such an American thing to do almost, though, to be like, we're rebooting this show. Get us the sexiest British guy you can find.
How long until?
Oh, my God. I feel like that's what they've done with James Bond a few times. Like just more handsome. More handsome.
I do find it odd that Daniel Craig is regarded as so handsome. Like, I think he's handsome in his own way.
Are you one of the people who says he looks like a potato? Because I've heard that.
But that's the thing. Like, yeah, he's another one. I think he's unique looking. So it's strange to me that he's, like, regarded by everybody as sexy.
Like,
he's got like very striking features, which I think are good, but I didn't think everyone else would. You know, like, his eyes are very piercing.
Yeah, he does have very piercing eyes. I don't like. I wouldn't look, dude. Obviously, I wouldn't say he's not handsome, and it's not like if I went on a date with him, I'd be like so disgusted that I'd walk out or something. I'd be like, whoa, no. But okay, you take a man like Pierce Brosnan, and he was just. He was kind of beautiful, all right? Yeah. Like, not just, like, handsome. I was like, he was just, like, he's, like, really gorgeous.
To me, he is the best sort of look that Bond has had, because that is how, in my mind, James Bond looks, is Pierce Brosnan. He's ridiculously suave.
I actually say this guy, Harry Von Gorkum, why wouldn't he put up for Bond? Maybe he was. Maybe he was, like, in the GoldenEye era. He might have been, like, in contention, because... He's got the Bond look down. He's wearing a friggin' tux, and that's for God's sakes.
That's all it takes. Although the tuxedo is leopard print, like the singer Richard Cheese.
I was going to say more of a Cat Slater from EastEnders kind of thing.
I'm thinking the lounge singer Richard Cheese, one of my favorite musical acts.
You know.